Alright, after we discussed the Axe of Evil, Wargaming, I just had to make that video. I think if you watch it in full, you will see, don't get me started. However, this is FreeBSD, or better saying GhostBSD, you know, there's GhostBSD, open terminal, your name I think still works, FreeBSD Voyager 11.1, so I never removed it, I couldn't do it, and I don't want to. So I'm using these systems because I'm testing them, right? If I wouldn't use them for a while, I couldn't give my verdict, because earlier or later I have to give a verdict, and my opinion, because I introduced it, and I said, look, this seems to be a good system, so I have to make sure it is a good system, because if I just say that, you know, then I can just fire an ISO up on a virtual box and call it not bad, not bad at all, wrap this up. That doesn't tell you anything, really, because if you have never used it, so far, FreeBSD or GhostBSD didn't give me any issues, so far. I mean, the issues we had, they're documented, they're on videos. Endless OS. I posted my own stuff here with my HP lasers, and somebody came along and said, you know what, do this, run a diagnostic file, post it. That was Leandro Stenger. And so I did this. I uploaded it. Nothing happened. So I sent another thing. Nothing happened. So I'm asking for an update 13 hours ago. So let's say they're in a different time zone. And not everybody has all the time. So I will be patient. Because that's a potential to make real money. You know, if they can't fix it, then I can go to the Pope and say, look, I performed a miracle. We should have Pilger coming in, and they should pay a small fee just to touch or see, maybe, just my computer. If they want to touch it, costs a little bit more, and they have to drop some money in a can, right? So, but not coins, better. Let's go for the paper money. Usually that's bigger and more, you know, and it can fasten more, so in the container. So, and then I get rich, right? I mean, who would have thought? However... Doug, you're bad. You're bad. So, when I was looking around, so some people had trouble here. Don't have VLC in App Store. So I'm not the only one, right? So here, Flatpak Untrusted, VLC Transmission Install. So there's more stuff going to happen. I found another guy not able to set VLC. That's something different. Haven't had this. I hope they're not going before me to the Pope and win the prize of having the Pilgers coming in summer 2018. Not starting after instead of Windows 10. Are you surprised? Windows 10 is made to destroy everything but itself. I mean, it destroys itself too, because you have to make money, right? So it has to go to the computer shop, and they have to fix it for you. But I saw here VLCs, version, okay. LaserJet Pro MFP doesn't print. So I didn't even try, because if I can't get the original drivers, if I can't scan, it's not working for me. I need to be able to scan and to print. By the way, Irish, he started fun to install part one. Yeah, I did that. So I'm interested to see when he installs printer. Irish, I'm watching you. Because fun to install, yeah, all works fine. It's absolutely easy. I showed that on a video, right? It's very quick. FreeBSD is super quick too. It's very quick install. It's not a big deal. Even now, since I put that video out, how to get the NVIDIA graphic card installed on FreeBSD or GhostBSD, it's not an issue anymore. It's a no-brainer. It goes quick. It was just a nightmare figuring it out so that I could make a tutorial, because there wasn't a proper tutorial out. There was tons of stuff out, but none step-by-step. Lots of people with problems, but nobody really put a step-by-step guide on how to get it fixed. So I had to trash a few systems a few times. I think I installed four times because I destroyed it beyond repair. But I figured out, made a video, worked. And I mean, the fainted heart subscribers are still coming. If you are fainted heart, do not subscribe to my channel. I get loud, I get angry, and I call a shuffle. And that is not millennium style, you know. Everything, oh yeah, peace and freedom, it's all good. Oh no, it's not bad when they lie to us, and if they lie and deceive us, oh, they're just so sad. Let's give them all our money, and oh yeah, they just give you the rules so that you're not disappointing them. what the heck? This is not the channel for you. So these seven people, good, you're gone. Don't stay in my channel. My channel is loud. It's ranting. Having said this, every video except the World of Tank videos and the Corrupt Company videos and spy software is meant to build up. If I test a system, it's meant to promote it, because I think there is potential and that's what I want to promote. If I encounter huge troubles, I rant, because I expected a lot. My microphone. Oops, is it back on? I hope it is. So if I rant, that means I expect a lot. That's why I'm ranting. And if you can't stand it, don't even bother to subscribe, right? Stay away. This, go to some other channels. I can give you a list where everything is just fine. The biggest rubbish shown, just fine. Go there. Don't stay at my channel. So, after we got that out, the hard knuckle stay, the fainted heart leave. Don't forget your water bottle. Otherwise, you might just faint out. Holy moly. Oh, look what I did. I got that. I got two fire water foxes now. Oh, by the way, I got sent a link that people say, oh, don't use water fox, don't use pale moon, blah, blah, blah. Because they say it's outaged, right? In my opinion, outaged is an advantage nowadays, because it seems that Mozilla is so keen in spying on people. Yeah, they give their excuses, but they're only sad because they're caught, in my opinion, right? Because they wouldn't have come by themselves and said, look, we made a mistake. No, no, they wouldn't have done that. So, to cut a very long story short, why did I have this here? Yeah, so I'm in the Endless Forum here, and there are more people have trouble, which is possible. Endless to Ubuntu, nah. Is the active pen configuration, the SD card port is not working. So lots of child errors. Yeah, like when a new car comes out, we call it child errors or child faults. Tux pin config, Dropbox does not start. So there are lots of little things which should work, because they are very important. If you want to have it for production, yeah, you cannot introduce your operating system to a company or small businesses if you can't get things like printer scanner running, if you can't get like Dropbox things running, what business use, and all these little things, you know. Yeah, that's mine here, you see, five views, so that's not five, no, five replies, but 30 views, so not many people could help. But we will see. I'll leave it on. I put some Flatpak things on. Like, I talked about my Synology clients, and they say, oh, no, you can't do it, because under the hood is different. So it won't just work that I can copy it over. So it's, that's not such a big deal. If you have Nextcloud, you could use Nextcloud. That would work too. I just could go in my Synology station and use the folder which I assigned to Nextcloud into my Synology drive. And then it gets synchronized at all times. What doesn't matter what I use. If I use Synology drive in a different way, it gets synchronized there. If I run just Nextcloud on a system which doesn't support Synology disk clients, it would still get synced to the same folder. So that maybe I'll make a video about it so that people know how to help themselves. So you're never really defenseless or stranded, because there are always ways to work around. So, yeah. I couldn't help myself with that World of Tank video, because it was just so obvious, you know, I had to make it. I got even one like. I thought I got destroyed. I get the crap for showing the real life of World of Tanks and their... how can I say this? I'm very grateful that World of Tanks is rigging continuously and persistent, because I was tempted, you know. I said, oh man, Defender, Defender. That would be $61 for a company which does that. No way, I keep my money. They don't get a single penny from me. I just watch them die. And that is kind of fun to see, because they die so quick, you know, they lose the player base in a huge amount. And the evidence that people buy accounts is, it's amazing. I saw tier 8 and 10 games, you know, and when people go in tier 1 games and tier 2, they just fire the gun and say, oh, look at this, because they want to see how it sounds and stuff like that, right? Which is exciting. But you don't have that anymore when you get into tier 8 or 10. Because then you had a few hundred or a few thousand battles. And then it's not that super exciting anymore. But you see these newcomers which bought the account and do the same thing. It's a noob behavior, which is normal. Which is not noob. It's just, I would do it. I think I did it. So, yeah, there's lots of evidence. So, what can I say to FreeBSD? Oh, look at this. I think I can just put that back in here. I'll put it here. Drain. There it is. So, I've got one water fox again. What can I say to FreeBSD? It is a rock-solid operating system. Let's see if there's an update coming. It doesn't seem to... It's a rolling release, as much as I understand. But it doesn't seem to have such a high amount of updates rolling in. It's very, very little, actually. It's neat. It's nice. I like it. I mean, since I have... I mean, it's a full-blown operating system. If you do office work, you can work with it. It does everything. No updates available. It does everything an operating system an office should be doing. The only thing I haven't got running is my Synology disk clients, but there is a Nextcloud client out, so I can work around that. My HP printers, they work fine. There's no problem with that. I can scan, I can print. You got LibreOffice. I've got network access, so I can have access to my NAS station, network access storage. There they are. And it all works just fine. So I even got OBS running. And the reason why I'm not doing this video on Endless is I think on the HP, the video quality is very low on my HP Pavilion. So I don't want to put that content on too much because I don't want you guys to get blur eyes and then you send me bills for glasses or contact lenses or even eye laser. Hey, eye laser, I saw how they do it. I feel comfortable I can do that. So if you need eye laser treatment, just come over. I bought myself a laser. I might have to point a little longer, so you have to hold still when I'm doing it. Otherwise, it's all your own fault, Dr. Dirk. Better not. Don't try it at home. So, yeah, but if... How can I say this? I mean, I'm a calculate Linux fan, right? So there's no way around it. It gives me a smooth feeling when I work with calculate Linux. I can't express what it is, and I think this is just the subconscious decision how we like distros, right? Some don't like this distro, some don't like Linux Mint, some don't like MX-17. I do not like Manjaro at all, and I would never install it. I did it one. I don't like it. I don't like it, I don't like it, I don't like it, I don't want it. I'm totally against it. Not just because that guy from Manjaro is throwing devil signs around on this Munich guy, Munich EU, whatever his name is. So I was texting, I was on the comment, I said, oh, look, is he throwing this devil signs as a, is it supposed to be fun or was that real? Never got a reply. So if people serve the devil, they are totally on the other side, I'm sorry. No business with me. That's my opinion, right? That in a moment I still can have one, but this prison planet is tightening the handcuffs, so you can't have free opinion anymore. If some people are offended, counts more than others. By the way, I think in 2016 everybody woke up and all of a sudden was offended of everything. What the heck? You know, take it on the chin. That's how we grew up. You know, people have different opinions. Let them have their different opinions. You know, I'm not judging people using Firefox. I would not do it. I would absolutely not do it. I do not run Windows 10 under no circumstance. It cannot be done to me. But I have a different level of pride, self-preserving. I don't want to be spied at. And if it's obvious, then no thank you. I'd rather not. And if Windows would really... I mean, I do not believe that Windows plays much better. Oh, how sensitive do you have to be to see if you I think I have 60 or 80 frames when I play. I can't see 5 frames more, I think. Who cares? So if I play that toxic game, or War Thunder is just beautiful. If you play War Thunder on Linux, it's a native Linux game. It's just fine. It's really nice. And it never is as toxic as World of Tanks because they have a different philosophy. Like, World of Tanks changed the economy so much that you must make minus, yeah? There are tanks, you have sometimes 20,000 credits minus, and you made 4.5 damage. So he did quite well, but he lost the game because, you know, rigged, or just these unexperienced players, which is okay, they can be it. It's no reason to shout and scream at them. They're unexperienced players, they bought an account. I wish they would have bought mine, but they didn't. So you lose the game, there's no way around it. And yeah, World of Tanks, why did they give me the warning? They don't like that I opt out because that makes their game rigging more difficult. Not when I'm on the losing side, but if they want to rig the game for the side I'm on, it's not because of me or the people. They don't care about the people. It feels to me like they want to make it toxic. And if you say something critical, you get banned. You know, that's in their country, I think. Yeah, usually there's, I think the Germans had that in Third Reich, so there's a bus coming and picks you up. So they can't do that, so they just ban me. Don't tell the truth. Do not be critical. We are doing good job. Yeah, for criminals. But you got caught too often. And, yeah, guys, when I say this, often I have these nodding dogs. No, there, you're bad. Get better. And so then you look at this performance of these players. They maybe fire one shot and do 200 damage. And I have got 3.5 or 4.5, and they tell me to play better. This is an upside world, right? Not that I'm the super player, but, you know, if you play a game long enough, you know, you learn a few tricks, right? So you can be good or better than noobs. And they're just noob telling me this. So I'm a little bit puzzled always to hear these comments. And I said, look, and I said, one guy, yeah, I have 64% win rate, you only 49. I said, guy, I saw your performance. This is not your win rate. You're very bad. We are blessed with a good random numbers that you get more rigged games on you in your favor. You're not good. You're really bad. It's not a blessing to have you on a team. So he became upset with me. So there we go, right? From FreeBSD, GhostBSD to Linux, like Endless OS, back to World of Tanks. See, it still bugs me because I don't like liars, deceivers, cheaters, crooked companies, companies who spy on you, and products who spy on you. That is when my hair and my neck goes up. And that's when I rant. And faint at heart, just unsubscribe, don't come back. Please, do not come back. If this is nothing for you, then this is really nothing for you. Don't come back, don't subscribe. So if you see that video by chance and you say, oh, he's so mean, he's a bad player, and he says things against Microsoft and it's ever so good, this is not the channel for you. I mean, really, it is not. You won't hear anything good about spying company which goes away with private invading people's privacy in huge, and where people sign a EULA which says you have no rights, we take your data whenever we want and we do whatever we want, and you're not even owning the system anymore. You won't hear anything good from me. No, it's not happening. And no, sorry, it's not happening. Why would I be sorry? Why in the world would I be sorry? So, oh, by the way, I saw a YouTube video about a guy, and he made a video with his zoom camera. It can zoom 83 times optical, and he zooms in 100 yards from him a building on a sign from a truck company. And then he zooms in a plane which is supposed to be 5 miles high, and he gets the same close. Something is off in our world. I mean, you know what I mean? It twisted my mind when I saw this. I said, what the heck? Because there's a logic behind it which makes you think, hey, what? Something is going on. However, I did my last driving hours with my senior driver. I go one more time next week, Tuesday or Wednesday. I think Wednesday we go to the city. So I will write down that route so that I can go with my students and give them the best training I can provide. Because that guy has 20 years experience, and that is what I would like to utilize. You know, if somebody has such an experience, that's what I want. I do not want to reinvent the wheel. You know, if these students drive with me, they pay real money and they have to work for it like everybody else. So I want them to have the most out of it. And I'm not one of, will not be one of those, you know, oh yeah, 59 minutes, the hour is gone. If an hour takes 1 hour, 15 minutes, that's okay too. Or you can drive an hour and do the briefing afterwards, which takes maybe another 10, 15 minutes. Well, that's okay too. So I will not be a clock watcher because people work for their money. I won't do the job for getting rich. I do that job mostly to stop people from dying here on the road for no reason. It's so much wasted life. If I can make my living with it, that's good. That's fine. I don't have to get rich. That's not the reason I'm doing it. And I think we all just live our lives, right? The world makes sure you don't get rich through working, and they even make sure that your kids get grown up in institutions, so that you have to have two people working now, so you can't grow your own child. So then they teach your child things, and I always have Bob Marley in my ears. Don't let them teach you, you know. Don't let them teach you. There's something wrong. Lots of these teachings are very, very wrong. So, having said this, this was my little rant. Calm down, dear, calm down. I got to calm down. Not with World of Tanks, that gets a full rust. And I'm just happy that I find, in lots of games, I find a huge number of players. As I said, I had games where I said, you know, this is rigged, I drown my tank. And then I had four people following doing the same. So, and of course, Wargaming is then very angry because the rigging doesn't make sense. They can't provide the fun experience for these premium tanks on sale on the other side, which are in the majority, so they get the better game, right? Because it has to be great. They have to send on a forum, oh, I just had a game. I did so much damage. Ah, you know, that's how they marketing their stuff. So that the crooked things happening is to promote usually. That doesn't work if these tanks are all drowned. They have nothing to shoot, so they can't say, I did 4,000 damage, because they say, oh, they all vanished. And that's fun to me. You know what I mean? In the earlier days, I was angry because I saw that game as serious. I started it when it was a good game, and I could not understand what was going on until they made so many buggy updates that the system crashed and crashed and crashed. And I figured out, you know what, doesn't make any difference. You play, it's the same result. You don't play, it's the same result. It's all the same. Doesn't make any difference. So, you know, and then I tested it. I waited for every battle to the end. I wanted to see every battle on the end. I did this for days and weeks and months. And then I could start predicting the outcome, because there's a typical thing how you see it. It starts with you're fully aimed 50 meters away on a standing target you cannot hit. Or it goes in your valve. It just puffs away. You shoot a blank. Or you hit, but if you hit, most sometimes you just don't hit, and then, but if you hit, you can't pen. Critical damage, and it drives further. You didn't even pull a track. You know, what was a critical damage? You scratched the paint? However, let's not get carried away. So, that is not my full conclusion now, but so far, can I recommend GhostBSD? Yeah. Can I recommend FreeBSD, because I installed that too? Yeah. So if you rather install yourself and theme yourself stuff, FreeBSD is installed in no time. It's very quick, it's very straightforward, and in no time you have XFCE running. There are some videos out from people who don't talk, they just write. They show you how to install KDE or whatsoever. I might have to have a look in KDE. I'm just afraid that then tons of updates roll in and glitches and stuff like that. I was very impressed when KDE had this, they called it LTS, long-term support, out, and it was good. It had no glitch, and but then they changed the LTS versions like daily updates. What? That's not any more LTS, and it wasn't, and the glitches came in, and that's why the moment I said, you know, not worth it, too much hassle. And then I had Arch, and Arch is every day is pulling updates in, which is good for those people who do all the troubleshooting and fixes, so that we have stable versions. But I'm not anymore there. I don't want it. My life has become too busy. My wife figured out that I'm responsible for the weather. How I'm doing it, I haven't figured it out myself yet. But if she says so, she must be right. So, this is a short video. I think I made a few points what I wanted to say. So, all the operating systems are still working. Having said this, the old slugware on Voyager, which never really worked properly, that is gone. That's the drive I used or tried to use for Endless OS to put it on my Voyager PC, which was never successful. After four installation, it just never worked. I changed drives and stuff, it never worked. Can't be installed. I would have loved to try it, because I would have loved to see if I can install the NVIDIA driver, because I haven't seen a tutorial there either. So, if you want to have it for playing, then you should be able to install Intel, AMD, NVIDIA drivers. So, but as we have seen, the forum is slow. It could be that the community is new. There are some views, not too many. not too many solutions either. Maybe it's in a different language is more. I can't say. But there's some common problems I found which other people have too. So that's not typical me. And I believe that lots of people who couldn't even insult, they're not even bothered. Yeah, Windows, I mean, my opinion, do not install Windows 10. I mean, Jack Orglaw, I think, he made a video about Windows 7. So now I had to call the treason. So, where is it? Where the, here, here. So he did it. He did Windows 7, but in a virtual box, so he's still safe. Windows 7, I use it in a virtual box. I must say here I'm guilty too. If I have something what really needs Microsoft, like in my driving instructor, they had for some reason stuff which did not work with Google Chrome, didn't work with Firefox, didn't work with Waterfox, Pale Moon, nothing like that. It just needed Internet Explorer, and Windows 7 had it, so I worked with it, and it did the job. All done, good. So I don't have any reason to fire it up. I still keep it for the odd days and see how that goes. I mean, I'm always happy if I never have to fire up any Windows version, right? So, I mean, usually as much as I know Wargaming, they will try to get that video off my channel. So if you ever see it vanishing, then Wargaming pulled some strings. They give some money into the balance from Justice, which is blindfolded. Or she feel the weight. And say, oh, yeah, yeah, this feels right here. So that's how it would go, right? Yeah, this is it. And I mean, look at the funny thing. 7 subscribers won, 7 lost. So, and thanks to the last subscriber, which is Pascal Christoph, I'm back. I even won more, which is funny. I hope actually that this channel is not growing too much, because I still like to have a close contact to my people. I wasn't very active last because I'm in the final of my driving instructor. I registered my name. I'm not telling you until I have it, because it does not mean if I want it that I get it. So it's registered, $45 are paid, and I'm waiting to for it to come through, and then I'll let you guys know what it is. Okay, that video is going on already more than 3 minutes. I have to cut it off. How can I ever make money here with YouTube if I have these super long videos going longer than 5 minutes? So I cut that video off. FreeBSD, rock solid. You don't get bothered with too many updates. Because of that, I can't say I haven't had anything. I had a few updates, very little, and they didn't break anything. I can say that so far. So I keep it running, because I want to see what it does. And I will share my conclusion after a certain time. You know, I have to see what it does in the future. I want to see some updates coming in to see if what it does. Bigger updates maybe, but it's good. I love it that it has so little updates, because you're not bothered. You don't get entangled, you know. It doesn't crash your system. You can still boot in. It's just workable. It works. It's rock solid. It works. And tell me if I'm wrong. It is a rolling release, right? I would think so. Yeah. Okay. I call this video off now. I hope you enjoyed this little rant information video. I just covered a lot, so I'm not know what to say really. I will call it something with Endless Ghost FreeBSD and runs. Let's see what that does. Okay, guys. Love you all. Stay tuned. Fainted heart, don't subscribe. Just leave. If you watched that video so far, it's not worth your time. If you can't, can't have strong words, and a shuffle is a shuffle. So this is it, guys. I'm out. Bye-bye. Bye.